नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज बेस्ट टाइम टू बाय एंड सेल स्टॉक्स. ओके, दिस इज आवर प्रॉब्लम. लेट्स सी द एरे फॉर दिस. सो दिस इज द एरे गिवन, विच इज 7, 1, 5, 3, 6, 4. This is the array given to us, and these are actually the day. The day stock value is day 0. Here I'll write day 0, the stock value is 7. Day 1, the stock value is 1. Like that. Day 2, the stock value is 5. Day 3, the stock value is 3. Day 4, the stock value is 6. And day 5, the stock value is 4. But what we have to do, only one time we have to buy and sell the stock so that we can get the maximum profit. Maximum profit. Okay? So that is our problem. So from this, if I say that if I buy this stock and if I sell at this day, so what is the overall profit I'm going to get? 5. So this is our problems. We have to get the maximum profit here. We want the maximum profit. And one thing we have to keep remember, that only this will be done once. We can buy and sell the stock only once. So only once we can buy and sell stock. So that is the problem. Okay, that is the problem. Now just understand that what is the, now you have to understand, if we see first the selling now. So if we see the selling, so before that buying should be done first, because if we will buy the stock, after that only we can sell. We cannot just do selling first, like here we have sell, but where after this, this side where we have bought the stock, we haven't, right? So that's why here first we have to buy, after that only we can sell. So this makes more sense. If I sell it here, if I sell the stock here, so that is most probably I have bought the stock here. And what is the minimum cost I will buy the stock so that I can get the more profit? If I will buy the stock at 7, so in the negative I will get the profit, and in the negative value, if the value is coming negative, definitely it is not the profit. But if I buy the sell, if I buy the stock at 1, if I sell it at 6, so profit I am making it as 5. Again, if I buy it as 5 and sell at 6, again I am making the less profit. So that is how we are going to see. Okay, so one thing you have to keep remember here is, so let me note a point here. If you are selling on ith day, you buy on the maximum price from first I minus 1. So if I'm selling it here, so I should buy as keeping in the mind that if I will buy it, so I will get a maximum profit. So that is the thing I have to keep remember while buying. Okay. Now here we can see that if I sell here, then out of this value, when I should buy to make the maximum profit? Definitely you are going to say 1. So if I'll say 6 minus 1, so I'm going to get the profit as 5. If I thought to sell the stock at here, okay? So I have hold here I can buy. So what is the minimum value I should buy so that I can make the profit? So minimum value here will be 1. So 4 minus 1, it will be 3. But the maximum profit we are going to get when? we are going to sell this at 6 and buy this at 5. So that is how we are going to get. So let's write the code. Let's try to write the code for this now. So here minimum we are going to take array of 0 because this is our minimum. Okay, profit always we are going to take it as 0 because we cannot take the profit as negative. Okay, that's why 0 is the more preferable one. After that, for loop we are going to use, I will be starting from 1 because here we have said that this is the minimum one. Then I smaller than n, I plus plus. Now cost, if we will calculate, so definitely the cost will be array of I minus the minimum one, that will be our cost. And now the profit, if we want, so the profit will be max of profit and the cost. So that is how it will be. So whatever the profit we are going to get, that is we want. And for to check, for to update the minimum value, we will write here minimum. It is minimum of minimum array of I. So that is how. So one by one, if we are going to take this as the minimum value, so definitely buying and selling at one day, the first day, it will give us the profit 0, and we don't want our profit to be 0. So that is why we are going to iterate. We are going to take the value here, then array, then minimum of this we are going to do, and after that we are going to calculate our profit, whichever is the maximum one, we are going to update this in our profit. But again we have to do the minimum value set, right? Like, see here, the minimum was this, but now the minimum to buy the stock will be 1. Okay, and the profit we want maximum. So that is how we are going to update. Okay, we are going to check, we are going to update. So first we will calculate the cost, after that we will calculate the profit, and then we will update the minimum. So that is how the continuous process we will do. And just remember that buying should be done first, after that selling should be there, buy and after that sell. Now can you just tell the overall time complexity for this problem? So here we are using just one loop, as you can see. So the time complexity here we will talk is n, and now if we talk about the space complexity, then it is 1 because no extra thing we have used here. Okay, now this was just the idea for the code, but let's try to write the actual code now. So int mini, we are going to take prices 0. After that, int max profit, which is 0. After that, int n prices dot size, we are going to calculate. Then the for loop we are going to use here. So for int I equals to 0, I smaller than n, I plus plus. After that, we are going to calculate the cost here first. Cost prices I minus minimum. That's how we are going to calculate our cost. Then max profit we want. So max profit here will be max profit and then cost. After that, we are going to update here minimum. So minimum, mini and prices. And now after all, what we have to do, we have to return max profit. Max profit we are going to return. So that is the overall code for buy and sell stock only once. And here I will write the time complexity for this is big O of n, space complexity for this is big O of 1. I hope you understood this. Okay, now let's learn the next way to see this problem. In this problem, as we all seen that we can only buy and sell the stock only once. But what if we can buy like any number of times we can buy and any number of times we can sell our stock? So that is our next problem, which is this time to buy and sell stocks as many times as we want. So this is a new variation for this problem. Let's see how we will see this. Now we are given array, and the array name is prices. This is, let's say now here 7, 1, 5, 3, 6, and 4. This is the array which is given to us. Now, first understand the question properly. Anytime we can buy and sell the stock, what this means? Can we buy the stock here and can we sell here? Okay. Can we buy the stock here? Can we sell here? Now, what is the overall profit we got? If we buy the stock at 5 and if we sell it at 3, what is the, we are going to get the negative profit, which we don't want. So let's not consider this. But if we buy here, both ways we are going to get the negative value. So in such case, we are not going to buy and sell the stock. But what if now here if I buy and here if I sell, again here if I buy and here if I sell, so what is the overall profit I'm going to get? So from this, if I have bought it at 1 and selling it at 4, so my overall profit is 4. And if I buy it at 3 and I'm selling it at 6, so the overall profit I'm going to get it 3. So what is the overall profit? 4 plus 7, the profit is 4 plus 3, the profit is 7. So this is my overall profit. But what if I do it like this? Now you have to tell me that, is it possible that we will write buy, sell, sell? So first we are buying the profits, after that we are selling it. Is it possible to do? No, this is not the case. We can buy, first we have to buy, we have to sell to buy the another stock. We cannot buy, and we cannot sell. We cannot do this. If we want to buy another stock, first we have to sell the previous one. This is very, very important. Okay, this is very, very important. As many as stocks we can buy, but we have to first sell to buy the another one. Let's say I have bought it here and I am selling my stock here. Then there is a chance I can buy the stock. Otherwise, I cannot. Okay, otherwise I cannot buy. So this is a way. So as we have seen that there are a lot of ways to do this. First, we can buy here, we can sell here. Another, we can buy here, we can sell here. The next one here is, we can buy here, we can sell here. Okay, but the thing which is not allowed is buy and sell. This is absolutely not allowed. Okay, so now just see this. Now we have to think logically. In the code, how we will do this? We have seen that a lot of ways we have seen that we can solve this problem, and we have to try all the ways, as you can see, to get the maximum profit. We have to solve all the ways. We have to sell this, we have to buy this, sell this, we have to buy this, sell this. After that, we can buy this, sell this, or lot of ways, every single way we will do. And we will try to get this. Okay. And for this, the best way, when we have to try all the ways, we will always move towards our recursion. Okay. We will always move. When we have to try all the ways out, definitely manually we will not do it, but we will give this task to our recursion. We will decide the first thing, how we will do it, the first few things. After that, recursively, it will do our task and it will let us know where we can get the maximum value. Okay, now let's understand. So from this problem, let's understand how to write recursion. Okay, so the thing is how to write recursion, recurrence relation or recursion. So first is we have to express everything, every terms in this way. So express, let's write this, let's write the bullet points here. Express everything in terms of index and buy. Okay, this is the index and I'm buying the stock. This is what we have to write. Second is we have to explore all the possibilities. We have to explore all the possibilities on that day so that we can try for the maximum profit. Later, what we have to do, third thing is we have to take the maximum, we have to take the max of all profits we made on that particular day. And fourth one is we have to take the base case. So whenever we talk about recurrence relation or recursion, the most important step is to decide the base case. Okay, so I hope you got this. Now let's try to write the code using all these 4 points. Let's try to write. So first point is express everything in terms of index and buy. So let's write this. So yeah, this is our array, which is 7 1 5 3 6 4. So this is 0 1 2 3 4 5. So now if we take it as 0 and 1, if we take the index like this, so index we have to take in this way, index and by, index and by we have to do. And one thing, whenever I will write in place of buy, I will write 1, that means I am buying the stock. Whenever I am writing 0, that means I am not buying the stock. So you have to keep this point remember. So this is index 0 and 1 means I have 7, I am buying the stock. If I write here 1 0, so that means index 1, this 1 stock I am not buying. So that is the case here. Okay, so let's see this. So we have to start on 0th day with buy. So if we will start with 0th day buying and selling the stock, so do we will get profit? Obviously not, because the profit will be 0. So that's why we will not try to do so on the particular day. So how to write the code, like is buy and now here profit. Now just you have to see this carefully. Now here minus price, okay, because we are here buying, so if it will go in negative, so that's why here minus of index. Plus if I want the index plus 1, like if I have bought this and if I want this to sell, okay, if I want this value to if I have to buy this, so index plus 1. And if I don't want to buy this, so okay, so that is what it is. So it is take. Now here I am taking, okay, here I am buying. And if I don't want to buy it, I don't want to buy the particular index value like this, if I don't want to buy, so simply it will be 0. Plus now I want to buy the next one, I want to buy the next one, so this will be index plus 1 and this 1, like this. So this is not taken. So that is what it means, that this I have not taken, but this I have taken. This is not taken means, and what is this take? This take means this I have taken, but this I have not taken. Okay, as you can see that in the profit we have written this index plus 1 means this I have not brought. So that's why this taken, this not taken. But here this value, this current value I have taken 0, and this value index plus 1 value I have taken, and as you can see here 1 is there, that means I have buy it. Okay, and here overall we have to take the max of this. So the max of this we have to take. Now I hope this is clear. In else, what we are going to see? Profit, which is again prices. Now this is all about sell. So if I have bought this, then after that in the else we are going to see the sell. So prices index plus index plus 1, index plus 1 if I have bought it. Otherwise if I haven't bought it, so index plus 1 I have not bought it. And here it will be, we are going to consider the max of this. Okay, and after that we have to return our profit. We have to return our profit. So that is how overall thing will look like. Now this is, we have converted here, we have explored. So first we have seen, we have converted everything in terms of index and buy. We have seen the possibilities. These are the possibilities. If I am going to buy, the next one I am not going to buy. If I am not going to buy, the next one I am going to buy. In the sell, if I am going to sell this, then I am going to buy the next one. Okay, if I have sell this, then there is possibility I am going to buy the next one. But if I haven't sold this, not sold this, then I cannot buy. I cannot buy. So you remember that if we will sell, then only we can buy. But if we cannot sell, if we haven't sell, we cannot buy. So these are the possibilities we have covered. And after all, we have written the profit. We have written the profit. Then we have also taken the max of all the profit we have made. As you can see here, we have taken the max. We have taken the max here. So this is what it's done. But now here when we were writing this, now the next step is base case. So base case, what we have to consider, this after this the base case will be if index equals to n, then we have to return 0. So if index is only equals to 0, then what we will return? The value as 0. We are not going to get any profit at that day. So 0th index, which means if index value is n, then definitely we are going to get the profit as 0. Then there is no stock left. So let's say now the index value. So here if we have bought the stock here and our index value is equals to n. So is there chance to sell now? There is nothing. So the overall profit, are we going to consider any profit at that time? Obviously not, because we haven't sell. So our buy will get waste. So we have not got any profit, not got any loss. We are in middle. So that's why here we are going to return 0. This is also possible. Like here I have buy, here I have sell. Here I have buy, here I have sell. Again I can buy. But this time I have reached to the max where I cannot sell it further. So in that case, we are going to get the profit as 0. So here the whole code will run and up till here it will end. Okay, so this is the first line. We are going to convert. Third line. Okay, now let's talk about now the time complexity of this. So the time complexity of this problem will be 2 to the power n. Because for every index value, there are two possibilities, buy or sell. There are two possibilities for every index. So n index is there. So the time complexity here will be 2 to the power n. And what is the space complexity here? The space complexity here is big O of n, because here we have taken auxiliary stack space. So that's why the time complexity, the space complexity here will be n. But now here in the recursion, when we are writing recursion, we always face the problem of overlapping subproblems. Means a problem is there and it is overlapping again and again. Even if I have solved this problem, again here in this case, I will going to solve this problem. But is it not, I've already solved this problem, so whatever the result is there, instead of solving here, I can just put the result here and solve the problem. So yes, that technique is called as memoization. So to overcome this problem, memoization is there. So if the interviewer will say, okay, the recursion we have seen, but can you just further optimize this? So further optimization is possible through memoization. So in the memoization, what we are going to do, we are going to solve this problem, memoization problem, with the dynamic programming approach. And dynamic programming approach requires the, if we have solved the problem, then we are going to store this. Memoization means memorizing the things which we have already solved, and we will use that. So that is called as memoization. So first we did recursion. After we have seen that this recursion is facing the overlapping subproblem, so to solve this problem, we are going to do memoization. Let's suppose this is the problem. I will store this result. Okay, and when in future I am going to get this same problem, I am going to apply the result even instead of not calculating it. So this is called as memoization. So for memoization, we are going to take dynamic programming approach. Okay, now let's see how we can optimize our code so that we can solve this overlapping subproblem. So what we have to do, as you all know, that we have seen index, we have seen by as the parameter. These two were our parameters. By we have denoted as, when we are not buying, we denoted it as 0. And when we are buying, we denoted it as 1. So index, we will change the parameter to n. Okay. And when we do memoization, so it means, what memoization means? Remembering whatever we have solved earlier. So storing, basically memoization means whatever we have solved, we will store that in some place, so that if we need same thing in the future, we will not recalculate it. Instead, we will pick the value, the stored value, and we will use it. So for this, do you understand the concept of dynamic programming? This is exactly what we do. We store somewhere, and after that, whenever we have to again use it, we just pick up the store value and we use directly. So here in memoization, we will do dynamic programming, which is our DP approach. So for DP, we will take DP like this, and in the array, and this by. So this by, we have two parameters. So here the size will be 2, which is either 0 or 1. Now, as you can see that we have already code, we have done our coding here. Okay. Now to change this in memoization, okay, to apply the dynamic programming here, what are the steps so that we can solve this problem using DP? So see, I am writing. As you can see that this index is equals to n, and it is written 0. So simply one line we have to write here, which is we will check that DP of n and by should not be equals to minus 1. So this is one check. Okay. And if it is so, then we will return our DP n and by value. Okay. So this is the most important check we have to do. And after that, just simple in this code, before this, we have to do, so whatever we are writing here, price and indexes, simply we have to write it as DP index by. In this parameter, if we will write, so this whole problem of overlapping subproblem will be changed to our optimized memoization. I hope you got it. So now, after doing this, after doing all the changes, what do you think is the time complexity for this? So the time complexity here will be big O of 2, because here we are using only two parameters for each. And the space complexity here will be, as we are storing it into the array, so it will be big O of n into 2. So that is what the time and space complexity. But now, can we optimize it further? Can we optimize the space complexity? Time complexity we have optimized. But is there any way that we can also optimize our space complexity? Yes. Now here comes tabulation. So tabulation is a way where we can order. So this is just because of auxiliary stack space. So we can remove this by using tabulation. Okay. So tabulation we have to use. Tabulation to remove the auxiliary stack space. Now let's see how we can tabulize this. So first we should know what are the ways we can tabulize it further. So for the tabulization, first step is to write our base case. Second is we have to change the parameter to I, and it will be by. So earlier it was index, now we are converting it to I, and the by same parameter is there. And simply after doing this, we have to copy our recursion as it is. We don't have to do anything. We have to just copy our recursion as it is. So that is what we are going to do. So here, when our index is equals to n, at that step, what we are going to do? DP n plus 1, 2. This is what we are going to do. Already we have seen this memoization. Same we are going to do. And here we are going to update our DP n 0, which is equals to dp of n and dp of 1 to 0. So all these parameters, first of all, we are going to update it to 0, 0. Okay, so that is what we will do. So here in this step, we go from n minus 1 to 1. Means from the last, earlier we have seen in recursion, how we go? From 0 to n we go, right? But in tabulation, it is completely different. From the last calculated value, we have to go to the first one. So this approach is basically going from last to first. But in recursion, what we have seen, we were going from 0 to n. But here we have to go from n minus 1 to 0. From last to 0, we are going to go. And here the by value will be as it is. 0 for not by and 1 for buying. So you already know this value, right? Yes. So let's write this. So this is simple. If you will add this, so it will solve your space complexity also. So the space complexity problem will also get solved. So I hope this problem is absolutely clear.